What are the latest trend lines in fund investment in 2018? ICI Senior Director of Industry and Financial Analysis, Shelly Antoniewicz, offered me a recent look at the data.
Although fund flows overall are down somewhat from the record pace that we had in 2017, they're still actually quite strong.
What do we see on the equity side of things?
For domestic equities, we have sort of a different picture between domestic equities and international equities. Domestic equities is actually where we are seeing weakness. Most of that actually is coming through the ETF channel. So we've seen much less ETF issuance in the first part of 2018 than we did in the previous year.
What about on the world equity side? Are people putting their money outside of the U.S. then?
That actually was very strong in 2017, and that pattern has continued into 2018. So investors, fund investors, both in mutual funds and ETFs, are continuing to diversify abroad. And that's been a long-running trend, and we see that continuing.
So fund investors still see upside outside the U.S. in particular, and that could be directing some of these flows.
And another factor is that other markets outside the U.S. in the first part of 2018, equity markets, held up.
Well, now, but that picture of what's going on the equity side, can we turn to bond funds, especially because in a rising interest rate environment in the U.S., people are quite interested in what to expect.
Mm-hmm. Well, bond funds last year in 2017 had very strong inflows. Not a record, but a near record pace. That strength has continued into 2018, and that is despite the 10-year Treasury rate rising about 60 basis points from the end of 2017. And that might seem surprising to some people, but one thing that we have noticed is that bond fund investors or mutual fund and ETF investors, fund investors in general, do not react instantaneously to asset price changes. Fund investors have long-term views.
Because fixed income is really what older investors want.
Yeah, well, fixed, you know, we see this in our surveys that we do, ICI surveys. We ask people for their willingness to take risk. And your willingness to take above average or substantial investment risk, which we tend to think is correlated to your propensity to hold equities, that drops off as you age.
So now having stepped through everything with you, it sounds like the overall big picture is flows, inflows do continue, might not be quite the fire hose rate of last year, and that we can still expect to see growth in particular in assets with the world equity category if things continue on the pace they've been on and with bond funds.
Yes, and I would note that recently ETF domestic equity net issuance has started to pick up. So, you know, the weakness that we saw in the beginning of the year could have been just temporary.